दैट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय अ चार्ज, दैट वन इज सोर्स चार्ज, सोर्स चार्ज. व्हाट इज द सोर्स चार्ज? द चार्ज विच प्रोड्यूसेस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज नोन एज सोर्स चार्ज.
सोर्स चार्ज
एंड टेस्ट चार्ज, टेस्ट चार्ज द चार्ज विच टेस्ट द इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज नोन एज टेस्ट चार्ज.
टेस्ट चार्ज
टेस्ट चार्ज इज जनरली वेरी स्मॉल पॉजिटिव टेस्ट चार्ज दैट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय क्यू नॉट. मीन्स दिस चार्ज इज वेरी वेरी स्मॉल एंड इट इज कंसिडर्ड दैट इट हैज नो फील्ड. मीन्स दैट इज वेरी स्मॉल, दैट इज नेग्लिजिबल बट हैविंग सम फाइनाइट वैल्यू साइज. सो दिस वन इज द सोर्स चार्ज एंड टेस्ट चार्ज. सोर्स चार्ज प्रोड्यूसेज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड ड्यू टू दिस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड द फोर्स इज अप्लाइड ऑन टेस्ट चार्ज विच इज लोकेटेड सम डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम सोर्स चार्ज एंड द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज इन डायरेक्शन ऑफ फोर्स. इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड मीन्स दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो डिफाइंड दैट वन इज फोर्स पर यूनिट चार्ज. दैट वन इज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, दिस वन इज द फोर्स पर यूनिट चार्ज. इफ वी टेक द टेस्ट चार्ज इज यूनिट देन इफ सपोज दैट क्यू नॉट इज 1 कूलम देन E is equal to F. It means the electric field is same as force applied on unit positive charge. And so it is very accurate to write the limit of this test charge is very small then force per unit charge that is electric field. So accurate form of this one is we have discussed. Means A that limit Q tends to zero, then F by Q naught. Where Q tends to zero means that Q naught is taken very small. And this is the accurate value of electric field. Electric field is a vector quantity. And SI unit of this electric field is Newton per Coulomb. We have discussed that one is. Electric field
yes,
is a three-dimensional picture. Means we have discussed that if we take positive charge, then electric field is radially outward. That is radially outward means that is in three-dimensional. It is a spherical symmetry. But we cannot represent it on the board. That is only represented in the form of plane. But actually that one is 3D. Means suppose that if a charge is located in the space, then electric field lines are emerge in all direction. And if the test charge is taken positive, then it is radially outward. And test charge is negatively. Or any charge is negative, suppose, then it is radially inward. This one is the direction of electric field. That one is the direction of electric field. That is radially inward, and this is radially outward. And due to a point charge, it is a spherical symmetry. A spherical symmetry means that one is three-dimensional figure. So this electric field apply the force on test charge. So we can calculate the electric field due to a source charge. Let electric field due to a point charge now suppose that if we take this capital Q is a source charge. Source charge means that is point source charge, and you know that electric field is emerged in all direction. That one is spherical symmetry. Spherical symmetry means it is three dimensional. Means if a test charge is located anywhere around this source charge, then it experiences the force in the space. Now suppose that if we take a point P where test charge Q naught is located, and then in this direction the electric field lines, that one is radially outward because this one is taken as positive charge, so radially outward in the all direction, and in this direction then a point P is located at some distance r from Q charge. That one is a Q charge, and distance from Q charge to test charge is small r, and the direction of electric field at the point in the direction, then force experienced by this test charge in the direction, that one is this one, when that one is the direction of the force. So we can calculate the force on test charge by this source charge by using Coulomb's law. So according to Coulomb's law, then force, direction of the force can be represented as means 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, and this charge that is capital Q, and this charge that one is Q naught, this charge, and this one is the distance that is r square, and we take the unit vector in the direction of this one. So this one is the vector form. Now we can calculate the electric field at the point P. So we know that electric field A is equal to vector F by Q naught. It is clear?
Yes, sir.
So
yes, sir.
We can substitute the value of force in this way. Suppose that is equation 1 and this can be taken as equation 2. So from 1 and 2, this electric field E can be this vector F by Q naught is equal to this one, means force applied by this one 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, that is capital Q and Q naught by r square into Q naught and unit vector, means this will be cancelled out. So this electric field intensity is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, that is capital Q by r square in unit vector. So this one is the electric field and its direction. Magnitude of electric field can be calculated. Means magnitude of electric field. That is magnitude of electric field. Electric field means E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught this Q by that is R square. Because the magnitude of unit vector is 1. So this one is the intensity of electric field. So now you are observing here from this relation, the electric field intensity depends on only source charge. That one is the source charge Q. And electric field is directly proportional to this source charge, means that point charge. If we increase the magnitude of this source charge, then electric field intensity will increase. And you are also observing there, electric field intensity is inversely proportional to square of distance from test charge. Means when we increase the distance from the source charge, then electric field intensity is going on decreasing. So electric field depends on source charge. Electric field intensity depends on the distance. Electric field intensity does not depend on test charge, Q naught. You are observing there is no test charge because the value of F and Q naught, that is constant. Means force per unit test charge, that is constant. That's why the electric field intensity depends on only the source charge, that is capital Q. So we can say that E directly proportional to capital Q and E inversely proportional to 1 by R square. So this one is the electric field intensity due to a point charge. So we can calculate the electric field intensity at any point from the given source charge. Then we have required the value of the source charge and distance at which we calculate the electric field, the distance must be given. So this one is the electric field intensity due to a point charge. Similarly, we can calculate electric field intensity due to several charges at a point. So let us discuss about that one is electric field intensity. Electric field means electric field intensity due to several charges means the charges are taken as discrete, means the different charges are given at a particular place and a particular point is given where we have to calculate the electric field intensity, then we can use the principle of superposition to calculate the net electric field, and direction of this resultant field can be calculated by using the law of parallelogram. So first of all, we calculate the electric field intensity due to several charges. Now we can also represent in the different way, means all the charges can be taken in a place and having the different position vector, or similarly we can also write the different charges and having the distances at the different. Suppose that Q1 is one source, that is point charge, and we take a point P where we are going to calculate the electric field intensity. So suppose that the direction of electric field intensity in this direction and the distance is taken R1, and this one represent the electric field intensity in direction. That one is a point. Another charge that can be taken here, this one is charge. Another charge that is Q2, and this can be taken as the direction of second electric field and having the distance R2. Similarly, we can also take that one is charge Q3, and the direction of electric field can be represented E3 in direction, and the distance is taken that is 3. And we can also take another charge that is Q4, and direction of electric field can be represented in the direction that is E4, and the distance is taken that is R4. So in this way we can take many point charges that are the Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 up to Qn charges can be taken, and then there is a point where we have to calculate the electric field. Then by using the principle of superposition, we can calculate the electric field intensity. Suppose this one is a source charge and the distance you are observing, if we place a test charge at the point P, the electric field intensity does not depend on the test charge. Only it depends on the source charge, means what amount of the electric field is produced by this source charge. Electric field intensity depends on it and only distance. So these are the point charges Q1, Q2 and Q3, and their distances from the point are represented by R1, R2, R3, R4 up to Rn. Then we can calculate the electric field intensity at the point P. So we know that electric field intensity means E, the direction of E can be represented by 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, and that Q by R square, and this one is the unit vector. So we can put the value of different charges and the different distances and its magnitude and in the different unit vector. Then we can calculate the electric field intensity at the different value at the point P. So then electric field intensity due to Q1 charge. So electric field intensity due to Q1 charge at point P. So we can write here that one is suppose E1, and 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, and charge Q1, and magnitude of this one can be taken that is R1 square, and unit vector of this one is R1. We can write like this one, that equation number 2. Similarly, electric field intensity due to Q2 charge. So similarly, we can write then E2, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, and Q2 by R2 square and unit vector that is R2. That equation number 2. And next electric field intensity E3 means 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught and Q3 by R3 square and unit vector that is R3.
Sir.
Yes.
सर अभी आप बोले मैग्नीट्यूड ले रहे हैं तो यूनिट वेक्टर तो 1 था ना
तो वी कैन आल्सो कैलकुलेट अगर हम इसका मैग्नीट्यूड लेंगे तो e2 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q2 by r2 square हो जाएगा बस दिस रिप्रेजेंट द डायरेक्शन ना सपोज दैट द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ दिस वन दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव रिप्रेजेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वेक्टर इफ यू वांट टू राइट द मैग्नीट्यूड नो प्रॉब्लम इज देयर e2 कैन बी रिटेन एज हियर 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught and q1 by that is r1 square. r2 square ले सकते हैं अगर second charge होगा तो that is r2 square. Magnitude of this unit vector is 1. तो this one is the intensity.
Yes, sir.
This is the magnitude.
Yes,
and
sir.
This is in the form of vector. It is clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Similarly, we can write due to n charge, En can be written as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. And that is Qn by Rn square and unit vector that is Rn. That is. By using the principle of superposition, then net field at the point P can be calculated by taking the algebraic summation of all the fields. So then, we can also take the total field at the point P. Total field at point. Field means that is field intensity. Is clear? Total field at point P. By using the principle of superposition. That E, E1 plus E2 plus E3. Up to dot dot that is En. We can write like this one. And this can be written as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q1 by r1 square and unit vector r1 plus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught and q2 by that is r2 square unit vector that is r2. A dot 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 we can write here that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught and qn by rn square and unit vector rn. Or we can take 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. This one is outside and we can also write q1 by r1 square unit vector r1. Or that q2 by that is r2 square unit vector r2. And that is Q3 by R3 square and vector R3 to dot dot that one is Qn by Rn square and unit vector R1. And this is the summation. So we can also write like this one 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught and the summation of this can be written as like this one. Suppose that Qi by R I square and unit vector that is R I that is I where I is equal to 1 to I is equal to N. We can write like this one and this one is the electric field intensity due to many discrete charges at the points. So we can calculate the electric field intensity due to several charges at a point. We can also calculate the direction of this net field by application of law of parallelogram. So it is clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Similarly, we can also calculate the electric field intensity due to continuous distribution of charge. Similarly, we have calculated the force due to continuous distribution of charges. We have calculated. So similarly, we can calculate the electric field intensity due to continuous distribution of charges. Continuous distribution of charges means same as linear charge density, surface charge density and volume charge density. It is clear?
Yes, sir.
So let us discuss the electric field intensity. Electric field intensity. Electric field intensity due to continuous distribution of charges. As you know that there are three types of the continuous charge distribution and density. Means linear charge density, surface charge density, surface charge density and volume charge density. Volume charge density. These are the different charge density, and due to this linear charge density, surface charge density and volume charge density, we can calculate the electric field intensity at a given point due to continuous distribution of charges. So let us discuss one by one electric field intensity due to linear charge density. So first part, that one is electric field due to linear charge density. Electric field intensity due to linear charge density. Linear charge density, you know that linear charge density means the distribution of charge per unit length is known as linear charge density. Now if charged object is taken in a particular place in a plane, suppose that we have given charge to a linear conductor, to a wire having the infinite length, and the total charges are distributed uniformly on the surface of this linear conductor or wire, and we can calculate the electric field intensity at a point due to entire charge distribution. So for this we take, suppose that one is a linear conductor having the infinite length and positive charge is given to this surface, and entire surface is covered with uniformly charged distribution, and टोटल चार्ज दैट वन इज कैपिटल क्यू एंड लेंथ दैट इज कैपिटल एल. सो लीनियर चार्ज डेंसिटी कैन बी डिफाइंड एज चार्ज पर यूनिट लेंथ. सो फॉर इट वी टेक द लेंथ एलिमेंट. लेंथ एलिमेंट में से एंटायर स्मॉल लेंथ दैट वन इज सपोज हियर दिस वन इज डीएल. डीएल इज द स्मॉल लेंथ इज टेकन फ्रॉम एंटायर लेंथ दैट वन इज नोन एज द लेंथ एलिमेंट. एंड इन दिस लेंथ एलिमेंट द टोटल चार्ज इज टेकन दैट इज डी क्यू. डी क्यू मीन दैट वन इज द स्मॉल चार्ज विच इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड ऑन डीएल एलिमेंट. सो लीनियर चार्ज डेंसिटी लैम्डा इज इक्वल टू दिस डी क्यू बाई डी एल आर डी क्यू इज दैट इज लैम्डा एंड डी एल. वी कैन राइट लाइक दिस वन. एंड ओ इज टेकन एज ओरिजिन एंड पोजिशन ऑफ दिस लेंथ एलिमेंट दैट वन इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई ए पोजिशन वेक्टर. सपोज दैट वी टेक हियर दैट वन इज आर वन इज द पोजिशन वेक्टर ऑफ लेंथ एलिमेंट डी एल. एंड टेक अनदर पॉइंट पी where we have to calculate the electric field intensity due to entire length. So first of all we have to calculate the electric field intensity and this one is taken as the positive charge. The direction of electric field is in the direction like that one and this one is the position vector and the point P is also represented by a particular position vector. That one is R2. Suppose that one is the position of this one. That is taken as R2. And this DL element, suppose that one is taken at point A. Point A means that DL is very, very small length. And it is up to a point A. So direction of A and P, the direction of electric field in the direction, and that one is very small electric field intensity, that is D in the direction. And then direction of this A and P can be written as R2 minus R1, and this can be represented as R. Means according to the vector addition, then value of
excuse me sir
OA plus AP vector it gives that one is OP. Hello
sir ye shayad kal topic padha diye the tino shayad sir ye tino topic shayad kal padha diye the aap.
Nahi nahi ye electric field intensity hai similar as the force on a point. जैसे फोर्स लगता है लीनियर
सिमिलर है
हैं
सर दोनों सिमिलर है क्या.
बोथ आर सिमिलर. अभी बताया ना कि इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी
वही कंफ्यूजन हुआ था सर.
इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड E इज इक्वल टू दैट F बाय Q नॉट एंड Q नॉट इज टेकन एज यूनिट चार्ज. अगर हम इसकी वैल्यू 1 लेंगे तो F और E द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ फोर्स. लेकिन अब अंतर यहां पर है कि इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड निकालना होगा. वहां पर दोनों चार्ज थे यहां पर केवल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी होगा. तो वे ऑफ एक्सप्रेसिंग इज सिमिलर. इट इज क्लियर.
यस सर.
हाँ तो वहां पर फोर्स था यहां पर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी है. तो वी कैन आल्सो राइट एज एपी दैट वन इज वेक्टर ओपी एंड वेक्टर ओए. सो दैट इज आर टू माइनस आर वन एंड वी कैन आल्सो राइट दिस वन. So this one. Now we can calculate the electric field intensity at the point P. So DL is a small element. That's why the charge on DL is very small. एंड यू नो दैट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी डिपेंड्स ऑन द सोर्स चार्ज. सपोज दैट दिस डी क्यू इज कंसिडर्ड हियर एज ए सोर्स चार्ज एंड डी क्यू इज स्मॉल, देन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी विल बी ऑल्सो स्मॉल. सो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी एट पॉइंट पी, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी एट पी ड्यू टू डी क्यू. दिखा दे रहा नीचे. सो नाउ वी कैन ऑल्सो राइट, बचा है ओके, फिर डी इज इक्वल टू 1/4πε0 एंड दैट इज डी क्यू बाई आर. आर स्क्वायर मीन्स दैट इज द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ आर स्क्वायर एंड दिस वन इज रिटेन एज यूनिट वेक्टर दैट इज आर नॉट एंड डी क्यू इज इक्वल टू दैट वन इज लैम्डा इनटू डीएल. सो we can also write the total intensity at a point P, then DE integrating the entire value 1/4πε0 and DQ by R square into unit vector R and we can also write here E is equal to 1/4πε0 integrating and the substituting the value of this one means lambda dl by that is r square and unit vector. Is clear? We can also write in the vector form. Khatam ho gaya. So now this is the electric field intensity due to the